My name is Bill Clevenger. I was in the infantry in Vietnam with the 25th Infantry. I was everything from a rifleman to a radio telephone operator to a combat photographer. This is a young kid who I took a picture of. Your typical infantryman. Here I am, age 20 years old, with a non-military haircut and a lot of hair. My primary here at the VA didn't like the way my lungs sounded, so she had some tests done, and they took a biopsy through the back of my body into my lungs. I thought that was the worst thing that ever happened to me, but as it turned out, it wasn't. It turned out that I have cancer in both lungs and was referred to Dr. Gupta, and that's where I've been going ever since.
I'm Dr. Pankaj Gupta. I'm Chief of Hematology and Oncology at the Long Beach VA Medical Center. Lung cancer is the leading cause of cancer deaths in the U.S.
Good afternoon, Dr. Gupta.
Good afternoon, Mr. Clevenger. How are you today?
Well, I'm pretty good. How about you?
I'm good, thank you.
Every year, approximately 5,000 veterans are diagnosed with lung cancer, which translates to about 15 veterans every day. Lung cancer is one of those cancers in which historically our standard chemotherapies have not worked very well. And if they do work, then the cancers become resistant to them. So there is a great need for developing better treatments.
My name is Nichi Wu. I am a board certified oncology clinical pharmacy specialist at VHA. He is a 74-year-old male veteran who was initially diagnosed with metastatic non-small cell lung cancer in 2019. So we were able to provide him with what we call a third generation oral anti-cancer treatment for his type of mutation.
The VA Lung Precision Oncology Program seeks to make sure veterans have the opportunity for the latest techniques in early detection, because lung cancer screening has been shown to reduce mortality by at least 20% with immunotherapy, which is boosting the patient's immune system against cancer, and with what we call targeted therapies that are geared to attack the mutations in an individual tumor. It's an opportunity to take care of those who have taken care of us.
Your scan shows that your lung cancer is stable, and so the gefitinib is holding it from growing. And so I think overall we are in a good place.
Well, we're 14 months into this, and I'm still walking and talking, so that's
yes,
good.
That's wonderful.
I see the oncologist's role as a collaborative one in walking the path with the patient and their family.
My wife and I just celebrated our 50th wedding anniversary last December. We're just the absolute opposites as far as brains go. But in heart, we are twins. It's been a very, 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 very good 50 years, and I look forward to many more.